I'm so happy I'm a Scotty. You look great. You look amazing. It's an exciting day. It's really hard to go after Oprah. I'm just saying. But thank you, President Kiesch. I'm excited. You're an incredible woman, and it's... Your partnership is so valuable, as is your friendship, so I thank you. I thank all of Agnes Scott, Beth Holder, thank you for leading a great board that believes in Posse. I thank the faculty, the staff, the friends, the family, everybody who's here. I thank Oprah for making me more nervous than I would have been. Okay. But it is an honor to be here and to be part of this graduating class, especially because I'm graduating with you and with the very first Agnes Scott Posse. Congratulations to you. So I'm giving the traditional charge. Here we go. We women have come a long way, haven't we? We always say that. We've come a long way. But long way is not enough. It is not all the way. We need you who graduate today with a stellar education in your pocket. We need you to stand up for the things we've been too slow to address. You are graduating today with a big choice. Because you have an Agnes Scott degree, your youth, and each other, the whole world is open to you. This makes you privileged, and it gives you a voice that not everyone has. It gives you power that not everyone has. And as you step off this stage with your degree in hand, your network around you, and your foot on the newly paved street to success, you have a big choice. You can choose to stand by, or you can choose to stand up. And I ask that you stand up. We are in a new and uncertain time in the United States. What is your reaction to the news, to the messages that we're hearing every day about alternate facts, about threats to national security, and about spending cuts that affect healthcare and Social Security and education? What message are we sending if we stand by? What message are we sending to immigrants, to Muslims, to the Black community, to women? This is not a partisan question, it is a human question. Whatever you end up doing with your life and career, I ask you, will you stand by or will you stand up? What role will you play to protect the very core of what this country stands for? I hope you agree that we must not stand by if we care about the environment and about human rights and about a woman's right to choose. We must not stand by if we believe that every American citizen has the right to vote without fear of intimidation at the voting booths. Our rights of freedom and speech and access to information and the right to assemble are precious, and we should protect them. We must not stand by. Please, we must not stand by. We don't want to create a future where we will face regret. We need to stand for the right to have strong personalities, to be brilliant and ambitious and still be liked. To be strong and still be liked. This combination of being strong and liked should not be exclusive to men. We need to stand for the right to hold public office, to change a Senate that is today 80% male to one that is representative of the gender breakdown of our country, representative of all genders. We need to stand against those who think sexual assault is material for a joke or a wink or a nod. We cannot stand by when we hear the excuse that violent comments against women are just locker room banter. We still, yes, still, need to stand up for equal pay. We are a civilized society in which the rights of all should be protected by all, by all of us. And we can't stand by if our rights are threatened by any kind of ignorance, bigotry, or misogyny. We need to stand. We need to stand, Sarah Elizabeth Fisher, Lacey Wilson, Maya McKenzie. We need to stand, Georgina Espinoza. We need to stand, Nicole Solano, Jasmine Shakur, Sitoko Mele Mabaso. To all the women of Agnes Scott College, if you have ever stood for a friend or a member of your family, if you have ever stood up for something you believe in, even if it was hard, I ask you now to stand. I ask you to stand. We are relying on you. We are relying on you to be strong and deliberate, clear thinking and compassionate, resilient and brave. We are mothers, we are daughters, we are sisters, we are women's rights leaders, we are civil rights leaders, we are human rights leaders. Look around. As individuals, we are strong. But together, we are an army. Congratulations, everybody.